Hello and welcome to the Penguin Prof channel. I'm Valerie Pennington. If you spend much time in front of a computer screen, you will have the experience where there's stuff on there that you have to share. And there are a lot of different ways that you can capture what is on your screen and then share it with other people. Now, the simplest way to do that is built into your system. So Windows users can use the snippet tool. On a Mac, you hit a few keys, Command-Shift-3, and you take a screenshot. Now, what you notice when you look at my screenshot is it's kind of a mess. You can see my desktop, and there's just a lot of stuff going on. And what I really wanted is to capture the whole web page, not just the part that I can see right now. So a tool like this, the simple screen capture, just isn't going to cut it. And that's where Snagit by TechSmith comes in. So Snagit is an incredible screen capture tool that does way more than just capture a screen, like taking a simple picture. It does cost $50, but if you are a faculty member at Southwestern College, you can get it for free. So if I'm trying to capture this web page and do stuff and share things about it with my students, and I use Snagit instead, let me show you the options. So to access Snagit, it lives up here as this S icon. And when I click that, it gives me options for what I want to capture. You can capture an image, a video, or an all-in-one video and image combined. And there are different parameters that you can use to make the selection. So first of all, when I select what kind of image I want, I have the option to select a regular image, a panoramic image. Panorama is really cool. It allows you to scroll during the image capture. So if you want to show something on a map, for example, that goes beyond, you know, the regular limitations of your web page, you can do that. It's awesome. You can just grab text. Let me show you this though. I want to select web page. Now, when I click capture, it's going to ask me for the URL of the web page that I'm on, and it's going to capture the whole thing, not just what I can see right now. So I can either drag the URL up into my little S icon, or I can copy and paste it into the box right there. So let's go ahead and paste it. Now, as you can see, Snagit captured the entire web page from top to bottom, and that's going to allow me to select the part of the web page that I want students to see. So the first thing that you notice about the Snagit editor is the various sections that you've got. In the top left, you have access to your library and all of the things that you have captured. You can click this little button right here if you want to capture something new. And here you can select templates, and you can also select to make a video and voiceover, like a screencast, from a set of images. This is your main toolbar up here at the top center, and you can customize this because there are, yes, more tools than are shown just right there. So the ones that you use most frequently, you can keep up there, and we'll check out a couple of them. On the right-hand side, this will give you options for properties of the things that you've selected. So for example, if I select text up here, then it's going to give me all my options for text. And obviously you can change the font and the style and the shadow and the color and the outline and the fill color and you name it. Let's get something that we can work with here. So I want to, first of all, crop this because I don't actually want the whole web page. I just want more than what I could get in a single screenshot. So let's select that, and I'm going to increase the size here of what we're looking at. So first of all, you notice how nice and clean this is. There's nothing in my desktop view that you have to worry about. This is just the web page. So what I want to be able to do is add a couple of elements here to draw my students' attention to a video that I want them to watch. So first of all, let's add some text first. So when I click on text, this is going to give me a couple of options. Here's the basic, and then what they call urban. Not sure why it's called urban. It's a little bit more modern, I guess. And what I can do is I can make this color anything I want. I can fill this with any color, or I can take the dropper. Let's do that because I want to match the color of red that's used in YouTube. So when I do that, just because I think it'll look nice. So now I've selected that as my fill color, and now I can click anywhere and I can enter my text. And of course, over here in properties, I can adjust if I want it in bold or in italics. I can change the size by moving the slider back and forth. So you can do all those typical things. Let's add an arrow also. So when I add an arrow, there's lots of different arrow styles. And I can again select the color, and I want to use the same color as I used for the font here. So now I've got red, and I want them to watch this video, reproductive number, there. I want to zoom up and show you just how much control you have over this, because it's pretty incredible. Look at this. This attention to detail, I just love. You can control the direction of the shadow, so kind of implying where the light is hitting this arrow, even though it's not real. So when I select the arrow, I can change the way the shadow appears. So this is the shadow to the bottom far right versus the top left. Do you see that? I like that you can control that level of nuance of the details. Okay, so let's go ahead and go back out. So again, we can see the whole thing. And this is perfect. This is just what I want. So I want to be able to put this, let's say, in my Canvas page, and I want to be able to show the entire web page section that I want them to see. And now I've highlighted the actual video that I want them to watch. This is a lot of work to tell students to watch a video. I wouldn't go through all this just for that, but I wanted to show you how cool this looks. When you click share up here, you have a lot of options and you can change what appears in this menu. So if there are particular apps that you always want to share to, you just select those. And that way with one click, it's there. And this is the image that we made. And in Canvas, of course, they'll be able to scroll down and see the whole thing. And it's exactly the section of the web page that I wanted. And it looks fantastic. Another thing that I want to show you about Snagit is some effects that you can add to images that will make them look absolutely stunning. So here's a Laysan albatross, and I want to capture that. So I'm going to click on my Snagit. I'm just going to select region because I want a region of my screen. And when I click capture, I'm going to get these crosshairs here, and I just click and drag to select my albatross. And now my albatross appears. And by the way, down here, this is your, they call it a carousel, the collection of your recent images. If you want to see other images, you have to go up here and click library, and that shows you everything. Okay, so what can I do to make this look even better? I can go down to the bottom right and click effects. And I want to show you a couple of effects. One is reflection. Reflection can be really, really lovely if you're trying to take on a slightly more artistic look. And everything that you see here in the checkered area, that is going to be transparent. So that'll be the color of the background of wherever you put this albatross. The other one I like a lot is perspective. And this is going to allow you to control the rotation as well as the tilt of the image. So I can control those with the sliders here. So this is the rotation. I'm going to slowly rotate back and forth. You may want a particular angle. I kind of like that because it gives you a sense of the albatross flying through the air. And then we've got tilt. And tilt can be nice if you want to make something appear more flat. I wouldn't do that to this albatross. I don't think it looks particularly good, but you may have an application where you want to apply a tilt. And I kind of like this just as it is. So let's share that to my desktop. And there it is. I think it's beautiful. So let's look at both of these in Canvas. Okay, so I've just uploaded both of these images into my Canvas page. And of course, as you know, you can click and resize. That's a little big. So let's bring him down and maybe center. And there is my beautiful Laysan albatross. I think that looks really cool. And here is the web page that we clipped. I wanted my students to visit, and here they can scroll down, and it looks really, really nice. And it only shows the portion of the web page that I wanted. So give Snagit a try. There's a lot of other really cool things it can do, and I'll show you some of those in upcoming videos. As always, I hope that was helpful. If you want to see more videos like this, check out my EdTech playlist on the Penguin Prof YouTube channel. Bye-bye.